It can happen that sometimes the people we love and think we know very well are hiding massive secrets. This happened to one Reddit user almost 2 decades after his grandparents passed away. The Reddit user's username was EvilEnglish, and he inherited his grandparents' farmhouse in Tennessee. Soon enough, you'll understand why the user wants to keep his name confidential. EvilEnglish needed to clean out the old farmhouse before he could sell the property. Thinking he would find a few precious items from the place where he spent carefree days as a child, EvilEnglish had no idea that he would soon discover something astonishing. The user found a huge secret in one of the closets that his grandparents had hidden for years. In late 2017, Reddit user EvilEnglish posted his incredible story of hidden secrets. He began by recalling his childhood of summer afternoons and pleasant holidays at his grandparents' Tennessee farmhouse. Originally, the house, which is so old that no one knows the exact date it was built, and surrounding land had been a working farm. Shortly after EvilEnglish's grandparents got married, they purchased the house, went to living in it full-time, and began working hard to transform it into a proper home. The surrounding farmland had been sold off by various owners just before the house was purchased. Right after getting married, EvilEnglish's grandparents left their apartment in the Deep South and moved into the house. "The house was a home for my grandparents for some 20-odd years," he wrote. "They bought this house in the late 70s or early 80s to escape the oppressive summer heat of the South." Even though EvilEnglish didn't specify where his grandparents moved from, it's no doubt that Tennessee does enjoy much nicer summers than the long, hard summers of the Deep South. The two turned the quaint little farmhouse into a beautiful home. To them, it was the perfect place to raise a family and spend the rest of their lives. It also seemed like the perfect place to hide secrets from their family. It wasn't long until EvilEnglish's grandparents had children. They became upstanding community members of their little Tennessee town. Friends and family viewed the couple as perfectly normal and happy. They'd created an idyllic life throughout the years, a family in a warm home, and no one could see any reason to move away, ever. The children of EvilEnglish's grandparents grew up, moved away, and eventually went on to have children of their own. Still, even though the family continued to grow, the farmhouse remained the center location for summer vacations and holiday gatherings. In between family visits, the couple grew old together. EvilEnglish shared that some of his most cherished memories were at his grandparents' house. Sadly, nothing lasts forever. Both of EvilEnglish's grandparents died in 2006. Thankfully, however, they passed easily and painlessly. The family grieved in the days after their passing. Even though they took comfort in knowing that the couple had led a long and happy life together, they still wondered what they would do without them. After EvilEnglish's grandmother's funeral, the family knew that they needed to figure out what to do with a farmhouse in Tennessee. The home that once brought them all so much joy now only brought them sadness. Regardless, none of them wanted to leave their beloved family farmhouse cold and alone. Still, EvilEnglish and his family had no idea what to do with it. Even though EvilEnglish's father became the one to officially own the house, neither he nor any other member of the family could live there, as they found it just too painful. So, none of the couple's relatives moved into the house. However, they still hoped that someone from the family would eventually live there. When EvilEnglish's father passed away just a few years later, the empty house was passed down once again. Instead of leaving it sitting emptily, however, he decided to do something different. EvilEnglish wrote, "My father passed in 2009, and we've been working to close out his estate and traveled to the farmhouse to prepare it for sale. The farmhouse needed to be cleaned out thoroughly so that EvilEnglish could prepare it to be sold. He had no clue he was about to uncover the long-standing secrets that lurked within the house's walls. The house needed some minor repairs before selling, and all the old belongings needed to be sorted through. Even though EvilEnglish knew it would be hard to do, given that he was the closest grandchild to his grandparents, he was still happy to do the work. He felt that it was finally time to allow someone else to enjoy the house with their family in the same way that his grandparents had. Evil English arrived at the farmhouse in Tennessee only to discover that the task would be a much larger one than he had initially anticipated. Not only was the house in serious disrepair, Evil English's grandparents had collected more junk than he remembered. Throughout the course of their lives, English's grandparents had become quite the collectors of a number of mementos. Initially, the number of items and pieces felt almost overwhelming to English. Would he ever be able to get through it all? However, English's perspective started to change. He realized as he walked through the farmhouse that he had been given an opportunity to learn more about his grandparents by going through their belongings. Soon enough, he was daydreaming about everything that he could discover there. Who knew all that he might find? English began to discover interesting collectibles as he started to go through the long-forgotten farmhouse, saying, "My grandfather was an avid sportsman and enjoyed collecting various firearms. And my grandmother was a collector of coins and other antiques and curiosities," he wrote. He also discovered his grandfather's pistol collection on the very first day of sorting through the farmhouse. As he continued to sort through the belongings, English recalled how his grandma liked to tell him stories. Sometimes the stories were about pirates and treasure, and sometimes she would tell her own real-life adventures, although later she would say that she made them up. Regardless, English still liked to believe that they were all true. Little did he know that he was about to uncover his grandparents' secrets that had been hidden from their whole family. English began sorting through his grandparents' things in the dining room and then room by room. He sorted through the living room and then the bedrooms. It all went pretty smoothly, and English ended up finishing much more than he had predicted he would on the first day. He still needed to clear out the closets and storeroom, however. He inspected them and found that the closets had even more valuables in them, telling him the most challenging part of the job was still ahead. At this point, nothing too incredible had been discovered. Regardless, English was enjoying his time in the Tennessee farmhouse. It made him feel closer to his grandparents. He decided to stay the night and clean out the closets the next morning, as he was satisfied with his work for the day. English woke up next morning excited about resuming the challenging task of sorting through his grandparents' collectibles. When he had assessed the closets the night before, he'd gotten excited and imagined all the things he might find. Sadly, though, he was disappointed. Throwing away all the items took hours. English's grandparents had filled the closets not only with valuables, but also with useless old items, like broken telephones and rusty kitchen stove. After the closet was emptied, everything looked normal, except one thing that stopped Evil English dead in his tracks. You see, the farmhouse had no carpet at all, but when the closet was completely cleared out, it revealed a carpet floor beneath. Why was there a carpet there but nowhere else? English knew the moment he saw it that something was off about the carpet. He couldn't remember his grandparents ever having any carpets in their home, and actually only remembered them ever talking about how much they loved their hardwood floors. Even though a ton of ideas rushed through his mind, the Reddit user just couldn't make sense of them. His first thought was that maybe the carpet was an expensive antique, but as you can see from the photograph, it was too old and dirty to be of any value. Perhaps he thought it came with a house? But then again, the house was way too old to have been built with carpeting. Evil English decided that there was only one way to find out. His curiosity led him to analyze the carpet closer. He closely examined it and noticed that it was dirty, ripped, and torn in several places. He was ready to head home and exhausted from cleaning the whole house by himself. Still, he knew that there was just something off about the carpet. The odd feeling remained, and he finally settled on the carpet needing to go. So he grabbed his tools and began to rip the carpet off the floor. He thought he would just finish this and he would be finally able to go home. However, English discovered the surprise of his life underneath the carpet. When the Reddit user started pulling the carpet up from the corners, he felt like something underneath it potentially broke. His first thought was that maybe his grandparents had put in the carpet to hide a broken floor. He hoped that he wouldn't have even more repairs to do. After this thought, he made sure to be exceptionally careful in the event that the floor wasn't safe or stable. English finally managed, after a few minutes, to scrape the carpet off the floor. Underneath the carpet lay a large piece of white metal in the floor. Inside the piece of white metal was a wooden circle. It just had him thinking about how he couldn't understand why his grandparents would ruin a floor like this. And he noticed that the wooden ring could be removed. EvilEnglish felt nervous about what he might find. Still, he chose to reach down and take off the circular piece of wood that was in the metal plate in the floor. While originally he had expected to maybe find an old pipe or something in need of repair, what he found was more complex. Underneath the wooden circle was a dial to a safe. Everything made sense to EvilEnglish all of a sudden. The carpet in the closet covered a safe, which must have hidden treasure. All of English's logic went out the window in a flash. Is it possible that his grandmother's treasure hunting stories could be true? However, the safe's combination still stood in EvilEnglish's way. Just like any other normal person, English tried to open the safe immediately. One Reddit post of his said, "I gave the handle a tug, but it wouldn't budge. If you twist the handle, it will still spin." He then, of course, began to try every combination that he could think of. "I spoke with my mom and she said that my grandparents had a safe in Florida, and the combination was my dad's birth date. She also recommended trying his social security number as a backup to that. None of the combinations are proving successful." Searching for any clues as to what might open the safe, EvilEnglish started going through his grandparents' mementos again in hopes of finding the right combination. Believe it or not, he tried every day for over a week. With no luck, he gave up and called a locksmith. English called a local locksmith, a man named Tim, to come out to the farmhouse after a week of his attempts to open the safe on his own. Tim reached the farmhouse quite quickly. After all, what locksmith wouldn't jump to the opportunity of opening a safe potentially filled with hidden treasure? Even for a professional, though, the safe was still difficult to unlock. English recalled, "Tim said about 30 minutes into this that if he had known what he was getting into, he would have referred the job to someone else. It looked like a complete pain in the ass to open this up. He had to keep his weight above the drill, and the workspace was very uncomfortable." Surprisingly, it took hours and hours for Tim to work on opening the safe. EvilEnglish paced around the room nervously, which, of course, added even more pressure to Tim. The several hours the poor locksmith worked felt even longer to the two men, as they were both so excited to find what treasure was hidden away in the safe. In short, it was a tough task. The time to open the safe finally came after almost 6 hours when Tim cracked the lock. As they peered inside, both men could barely stop their hands from shaking. Initially, as the lid of the safe opened, the only thing that Tim and EvilEnglish could see was a bunch of bricks and stones surrounded by water. As one could imagine, the men were extremely confused. Just as English began to wonder why anyone would fill a safe with bricks and water, it dawned on them. EvilEnglish wrote, "I remember that there was a pipe leak in the house a few years back. I'm sure some of the water from that had accumulated in the safe." Even though the bricks seemed pretty useless, English swore that he could see something beyond the bricks. It looked like a pile of books or boxes. Is it possible that these were the antique treasures English's grandmother had told him stories about when he was a kid? Everything started to become much clearer as he dug deeper into the safe. The two men's expectations started to dip as they began removing the items from the old safe. At first, when English and Tim removed all the bricks, it didn't really seem like the safe held much value and appeared as though they only contained empty boxes, a handful of coins, and books that had been damaged by the water. Just as EvilEnglish started to think that all the hard work he and Tim had gone through was for nothing, he decided to take a look at each object. It wasn't long until English realized that the contents of his grandparents' hidden safe held more value than he initially thought. On top of that, there was more hidden treasure inside the safe. English and Tim found more and more hidden treasures as the two men continued to remove objects and rubble from the safe. As English examined the objects and coins, he felt like he was traveling back through time. He realized that almost all the safe's belongings were from an entirely different era. The Reddit user knew that the pieces from the safe had to be valuable. After all, why would his grandparents have locked them away in a safe? One of the first things that EvilEnglish pulled out from a safe was a 1937 coin book. Even though he didn't know much about collectible coins, he knew that antique coins could sell for a lot of money. English began to realize, as he pulled out more and more coins from the safe, that his grandparents were true coin lovers. Their passion for coinage began to feel a lot more like an obsession as he and Tim removed literally thousands of coins. A smile was brought to the Reddit user's face as he thought of his grandparents' adoration of the little coins, which were from all over the world. English and Tim found many relatively recent and standard issue coins in the safe too. They also found some coins in the collection that seemed extremely rare and unique. Sadly, however, not everything from the safe could be saved. Even though there was quite a bit of damage from the water from the roof leak, most of the coins survived. The moisture in the safe makes the covers very mushy, but the coins inside are in surprisingly good shape, English recalled. There were so many rolls of coins down there. Some of them were in plastic tubes, but more were unfortunately in paper tubes. However, the hidden treasures didn't stop at just coins. There were a ton of dollar bills. Sadly, though, they were deemed unusable as all of them were ruined by water damage. Although, English soon came across even more hidden treasures from within the safe. He was still a bit disappointed to have to throw out the dollar bills. While many of the dollar bills were too ruined from water damage to be salvaged, there were still a few things EvilEnglish found that he thought he might be able to sell for cash. Some of these things were some bills which had been signed by the Secretary of Treasury in 1968. This photo shows his ink signature on the bottom left of a dollar below. On top of that, artifacts from Barr's time in power are extremely unique as he was only secretary for a month. Thank goodness the Barr bills were kept wrapped in plastic. EvilEnglish was beginning to realize that he was looking at a gold mine. And just when he thought the bar bills were an amazing find, nothing could prepare the two men for what they were about to find next. The Reddit user set aside the coins and destroyed cash to continue pulling out even more valuable items from the safe. His grandparents' hidden treasure also contained multiple pure silver bars. Not just that, his grandparents had even made sure to place the silver's manufacturer paperwork right alongside the bars. This meant that English could easily prove the bars' authenticity and therefore value. But those weren't the only surprises. EvilEnglish came across an old, rusty box which, to him, resembled nothing more than a small and worthless toolbox. At this point, however, he knew better than to take any chances. This box might hold the safe's biggest secret yet. Yet again, the Reddit user was filled with excitement. Eventually, he was able to break into the old toolbox from the safe. However, the toolbox was actually a jewelry box, as it contained just that, jewelry. While some pieces had suffered some water damage, English was happy to have most of the items still in good condition. Some of the pieces included several pocket watches and wallets, as well as more gold and silver jewelry. English was in total shock. He had no idea that his grandparents had spent a majority of their lives collecting such amazing and unique objects. And the fact that they had owned such possessions and kept these treasures hidden from he and his family. That was what EvilEnglish couldn't quite figure out. Strangely, English trusted these hidden valuables less after removing them from the hidden safe. With all sorts of questions in his mind, like, why had his grandparents hidden these things for all this time? He decided that he would need to search the whole place. English wanted to make sure there weren't any more hidden treasures in the old farmhouse. As he looked, he noticed an unsuspecting-looking coffee table, one that he couldn't recall his grandparents ever using. Originally, when EvilEnglish had been cleaning, he had thought it was just another piece of rotting furniture. Now, he knew better. The Reddit user would leave no stone unturned. He would make sure to go through every drawer of the coffee table. As he opened the first drawer, he discovered yet another truly unexpected and unusual find. When EvilEnglish opened the first drawer of the unsuspecting-looking coffee table, you might not believe it, but he found yet another safe. The second safe had yet even more hidden treasures waiting for him. English's grandparents had truly placed some incredible goods in even better hiding places. In only 2 days, this young man had brought to light two of his grandparents' biggest secrets. Yet again, EvilEnglish was bursting with excitement. Walking over to a work table, he brought the second safe over and began trying to open it. Although the safe was smaller than the first, this one opened much easier. When he finally opened it, his jaw dropped. He was shocked to find something dangerous in the safe. The second safe found in EvilEnglish's grandparents' home ended up containing a hidden treasure of one of his grandfather's favorite collectibles, pistols. English wasn't surprised by this discovery, as he knew his grandfather was an avid collector of antique artillery. The only issue was that he had no clue what to do with them, as it wasn't like he could go out and sell them to a gun shop. English continued to search the house, but didn't find much more. He then was faced with one of the toughest choices of his life. Should he keep these treasures that belonged to his grandparents or sell them for money? Because English faced such a dilemma, to keep his grandparents' beloved mementos or sell them off for cash, he decided to take it to the popular online forum, Reddit. It was there that he shared his story about how his grandparents had passed away and left their farmhouse and these hidden treasures in his possession. Many suggested to English that he should simply keep the items for himself and his family as nice reminders of his loving grandparents. Others suggested keeping them simply because many of the pieces were so damaged and that it was likely they wouldn't be able to sell for more than $100. At the same time, others told him that the hidden treasures might be pretty valuable, regardless of if they were damaged. Not all commenters thought that the damaged coins had lost value. One professional coin collector commented and told EvilEnglish that there was a good reason the grandparents kept coins and bills in a safe. "Collectible coins are worth everything," he said, "even if damaged. Notes are often collectible as well. Check everything, even if damaged, they can still have great value." At the same time, another commenter wrote, "Just so you know, anything from 1964 or older with 90% silver is worth about 20 times the face value of the coin. 50 cents is $10, 25 is 5, 10 is $2. Not to mention the silver bars, they're worth about $22.10 per ounce." It's no surprise that EvilEnglish and his family felt emotional after finding the incredible mementos that belonged to their late loved ones. After paying the locksmith Tim, of course, the family decided that they would each keep any items that were significant for them and sell the rest. EvilEnglish's keepsakes were some of the coins, as whenever he sees them, they remind him of the treasure hunting stories his grandma used to tell him. The question is still, what about the rest of the hidden treasures? The last anyone heard was that he was debating between taking all the items to an auction house or selling them individually to collectors. Sadly, even though some of the items have been spotted at auctions, it's highly likely that we'll never really know what happened, and for a good reason, too. Just as everyone was on the edge of their seats, waiting to hear what EvilEnglish would do next, he deleted many of his posts that talked about his grandparents' farmhouse treasures. Luckily, he returned and updated everyone later, explaining his reason for pulling the posts. After he had posted about the treasures, EvilEnglish started receiving threats that people were going to track him down and steal his stuff. To be safe, he simply got rid of the posts. So, here's some advice. When you come across anything valuable such as collectibles, wait a bit to share it with the internet until after you have gotten rid of the items.